Namaste. In our continued bliss to enjoy Sri Krishna's names as it appears in Srimad Bhagavad Gita, we are here in yet another episode to enjoy another divine name of Sri Krishna. Now, this is a name, is it directly addressed to Krishna or one of his components is what we are going to see. As we are in the 11th chapter, we have been experiencing a lot of things in the last few weeks on the 11th chapter. 11th chapter, we all know, it's the chapter where Sri Krishna shows his Vishwarupa. And we have also seen Arjuna going through different emotions, varied emotions through this chapter. In the 10th chapter, he requests Krishna to show the entire Aishwaryam. Can I see the entire Aishwaryam is what he is requesting. And in the 11th chapter, we see that Krishna blesses him with the Vishwarupa Darshana. What more Aishwaryam you need to see the Lord in his entire form. But then we also saw a trembling Arjuna, who just can't fathom the size and scale of the Vishwarupa, request Sri Krishna to come back in his usual form with four arms. In the process, he also realizes that where he stands and where Paramatma stands, and also begs forgiveness for treating him on par, sometimes taking Sri Krishna for granted, and various other things. We experienced the way Arjuna has been experiencing, we have also been experiencing learning from him. Now, in this process, we all know Arjuna is known for his valor, he is respected for his valor, he is celebrated for his valor. So as he is celebrated for this valor, he is also being crowned for his glory in this valor and ability to drive things to get results. So we are now going to talk about crown, Kiridim. Kiridinam is a name that we are going to enjoy in this episode. Let us look at the slokas now.
Kiritinam gadinam chakrinam cha tejo rashim sarvato deeptimantam pashyamitvam durniriksham samantat deeptanalarka tyutimaprameyam kiritinam gadinam chakrahastam ichhamitvam द्रष्टुमहं तथैव तेनैव रूपेण चतुर्भुजेन सहस्रबाहो भव विश्वमूर्ते.
The 11th chapter, 17th sloka and 46th sloka, Kiritim is the term that is used by Arjuna to address Sri Krishna. The 17th sloka is as he sees and experiences Krishna in his Vishwarupa. And in the 46th sloka is a more realized Arjuna, a more balanced Arjuna now after seeing the greatness of Sri Krishna, now again addressing Kiritim. Now as we saw that Arjuna was also given this name Kiritim because of his celebration of his valor, then now realizes the actual Kiritim is the Paramatma who is standing in front of him. Because what is a crown after all? I mean, we are all talking about giving an icon or the ISO standards and all that. The earlier Sanatana Dharma system, our whole monarchical system, people used to identify the status of a person by certain amount of dresses, certain amount of crown that they used to wear. We had kings who were ruling a shorter areas, you have kings who were ruling a larger area, under whom the shorter area kings were reporting to. Then we had the emperors who were having a large area, Chakravarti as we say, was there. We can be sure if we are able to trace all those things and get the original pictures wherever it is, the size of the crown would change to depict who is an emperor. And here we are talking of Lord of Lords, Emperor of Emperor, Rajadi Raja, the Purushottama, Sri Krishna. So how his kiritim will be? The real imagination itself gives us a scale and the size and the composition of the kiritim in such glory that Arjuna here is seeing directly all that, and now he says this kiritim belongs to you only, Krishna, because I can be a king for my own territory, but you are Raja Adhi Raja. And where have we seen this? We have seen this in earlier Tirunama as Purushottama, Sarvaloka Maheshwara. We have seen that Sarvaloka Maheshwara, Lord of the universe, right? So who else can be that other than Krishna? And for him kiritim is very, very important. So here Arjuna enjoys, realizes the term kiritim belongs only to Sri Krishna, and with bhakti and devotion keeps offering that you are the supreme and then keeps prostrating to Sri Krishna in all directions, seeks forgiveness again and again and again. We see that through the 11th chapter, as Arjuna realizes Krishna more and more, that Krishna is a Paramatma, not just his uncle or cousin or a friend, he is Sarvaloka Maheshwara. You see Arjuna begging forgiveness, prostrating and offering his surrender, offering his respects and all that on a continuous basis. And that is the state of mind of Arjuna. Because through Arjuna, it is all our state of mind too. Because there are times that we take Sri Krishna for granted. Now, it is very, very important that Sri Krishna, through Arjuna in the 11th chapter, tells us that he is the Sarvaloka Maheshwara, he is the Lord of everything. And we better have the respect and always offer our respects to Sri Krishna. He is there waiting to put his arm around his shoulders. That doesn't mean we take Krishna for granted. We need to continuously show respect and love and bhakti to Sri Krishna constantly, and that is what Arjuna is now doing. An interesting episode that happened in which has been listed in the Bhagavata Purana and all that is about the greeting. The crowning glory of Sri Krishna, Sriman Narayana, has been respected, has been enjoyed and celebrated by Mahacharyas. Swami Desikan, in one of his works, has mentioned about it. Madhvacharya has mentioned a very interesting episode, in a Puranic episode, in his works. So there are a lot of people who enjoy it, because Swami Desikan, in Bhagavad Dhyana Sopanam, Sopanam means a ladder. So he is using the thoughts of the Bhagavan as a ladder from to worship him from the feet to his head, and then enjoy the bliss of Sri Ranganatha, the worship of Sri Ranganatha and Sri Rangam, where he is thinking, actually there is an alvar called Tiruppan Alvar, who has written 11 verses worshipping and enjoying the Lord from his divine feet to his face. So Swami Desikan eulogizes the same, based on that alvar's work, came up in the Sanskrit work, in Sanskritam, which is called Bhagavad Dhyana Sopanam, where in the Sopana he is enjoying the Lord based on each of his divine parts. So first he is paying his obeisance to the divine feet, then he moves to his shoulder, thighs and all those things. But there is a very interesting thing. Sri Krishna or Ranganatha here in this context has got a very amazing quality. What is that? When you are worshipping one of his body parts, we can be sure that it attracts you and takes all your attention there, that we even forget that the Lord is there in other forms actually. We have seen this many times. We go to the temple and we get the darshan of the divine feet. We don't even look at his netra, we don't look at his shoulders. There are times, certain temples that we have to climb up like this. If you go to Kanchipuram and you want to have the darshan of Varadaraja, you have to climb few stairs and look. So the Lord starts looking at you much ahead before you can even have his darshan of his divine feet. So what happens? You start looking at his chubby cheeks. Then you will forget to go look at his divine feet, because his chubby cheeks and the smile has already attracted you and captivated you. Like this, everywhere this happens. Somewhere you see his shoulders, then you just forget that everything else. His shoulders take all the attention. If you go to Madurai, there is a temple called Alagar Kovil, where the Lord is called Sundara Bahu. His Bahu, his shoulders are supposed to be so beautiful that you end up being captivated just by his Bahu, his shoulders. So like this, every part gets you captivating. So you, by the time you move from one part to another part, it will take ages when you have this true bhakti. So Swami Desikan is doing this, and when he comes nearer to his crown, he says, I've been in confusion for all along. Now I'm completely clear, hey Ranganatha, on seeing your crown, because your crown establishes, you are Sarvaloka Maheshwara, you are the Lord of the universe, I have no doubts here and forth. And that is what Swami Desikan says in Bhagavad Dhyana Sopanam. Similarly, Madhvacharya mentions another episode, a Puranic episode, where Sriman Narayana, in his Milky Way, or Shirabdi, is reclining and in his Yoga Nitra, along with Mahalakshmi. There are various rishis, acharyas around them, around Sriman Narayana there. But at that time, Prahlada's son, Virochana, happens to walk in. He sees everybody is quiet in a penance or something, and Sriman Narayana is in his Yoga Nitra. He just looks around. And obviously, amongst many things, the crown attracts or captivates Virochana. Virochana keeps looking at it and then sees everybody is in their penance. Why don't I just take it to my place? And quietly takes it. He quietly takes it from the Lord himself, a crown. Now we spoke about the crown, how it will be for an average king. We saw the crown of Ranganatha here in a temple in Shirabdi for Mahavishnu. What kind of crown it will be? The glory of the crown, by not just by the kind of precious metals it will have, but just the crown, because it adorns Shrimad Narayana. What glory, what size, what scale it will be. Virochana, being himself, he quietly took it and slipped away. He thought he slipped away. Everybody else are laughing and says, here is going a laughing stock, and Shrimad Narayana allowed, let him take it. Where he is going to go, I will take care of it. And then, but Garuda was observing this and he was not too happy. He says, my lord is without his crown. It's not done. He is the Sharuloka Maheshwara. Now I am going to get it. But by the time Garuda decides to go and bring it, Virochana is taken to the Bathala Loka. Now, where is Bathala Loka? We saw in earlier episodes, there are seven lokas above and seven lokas below. Bathala is the seventh lowest loka. So Virochana is able to go fast and put the crowns, keep it in custody there at the lowest of the lokas. Garuda, being Garuda, goes there, challenges Virochana into a fight and brings back the crown. As he brings back, he crosses the Mathura and he sees that little Krishna, Shri Narayan is now as a Sri Krishna, is there walking around with the meadows and all that. But he sees just with a feather, a peacock feather, with no crown and all that. Again, Garuda says, oh, my lord is without crown. It is so much a scorching heat. He doesn't even have something to protect his head. And he goes and fits it on the young Krishna, on the little Krishna. Now, the greatness here is, the crown of Shriman Narayan and Shirabdi fits exactly the little Krishna who is there in the Mathura. That's how. But as he fits it here, Shriman Narayana also accepts it in Shirabdi. He is also adorned with the same crown there in Shirabdi. The Purana has said that later Sri Krishna presented this crown to the Sampat Kumara. The murti is named called Sampat Kumara in Melkote near Mysore. People who have had darshans in Mysore, Melkote, or people who have not, should definitely have this darshan of this lord called Sampat Kumara or Selva Pillai. Krishna adorns this crown to him, and today it's a utsava that is celebrated every year called Vairamudi Sevai or Vainamudi Sevai. Garuda is also called Vainateya because this crown was brought by Garuda. It is also called Vainamudi, and it is adorned with so much of diamonds, it is also referred as Vairamudi. So that kind of glory, that is what a crown has. And this is for the crown, Arjuna is now respecting, saying that the crown belongs to the true emperor, true Sarvaloka Maheshwara, that is you, Krishna. That is why he says, creating, you are the true owner of the creating. Now here is one who was given the creating as a celebrated title to Arjuna, but Arjuna says, I am a mere human. Sarvaloka Maheshwara needs this title called creating, and he worships Sri Krishna for all that glory, that this crown belongs to the Sarvaloka Maheshwara. So let us worship Sri Krishna's creating with the complete faith and belief and understanding that Sri Krishna is the Sarvaloka Maheshwara, and be blessed always. Namaste.
Madhava Achyuta Krishna Hare Rishikesha Keshava Govinda Vasudeva Bhagavan Janardana.